Because it's a frequently asked question, let's take a look at programming multi-criteria sensors.
It is important to know how multi-criteria sensors operate in order to program them correctly. System Sensor by Honeywell makes these for a multitude of brands, such as Gainwell FCI under the MCS-COF3 and Notifier under FCO-951. They're also available for Firelight and Silent Night. Gainwell FCI uses the CamWorks program for these devices. Input column 1 becomes true when the smoke is activated. Column 2 becomes true when the CO element is activated. And columns 3 and 4 are true when the heat sensor is activated. By programming a unique input group on each column, we can then program the system with LEDs to watch which element activates which column. We've programmed these four LEDs to activate with each of the three different elements of the detector. For this test, we are using the Gainwell FCI MCS-COF3 detector. First up will be the smoke test. We'll activate the smoke element of the detector. Activating the smoke element activates just the first column in the program. Next, we'll activate the CO element of the detector. Now that the CO element is activated, let's see which column is true. Carbon monoxide activates the second group column in the program. Finally, we'll use a listed heat source and activate the thermal sensor and see which columns become true in this case. Activating the thermal element causes columns 3 and 4 to become true. If you enable sounder bases, the default sound output is a temporal 3, even for the carbon monoxide alarm. If you need to have a temporal 4, which you do, you're going to need to assign groups on these two columns here at least, and then assign an output group to control the base. To control the sounder bases individually, these assigned groups need to be unique. If you have a couple of rooms that have multiple detectors, you can have them operate in tandem by just duplicating the group numbers that you assign. The next step is to program the output groups that were assigned to those detectors. The first group here is for the smoke, the second one is for carbon monoxide, and the third one is general alarm. The second detector, we did not attach general alarm to it. It's going to depend on your job specifications. To get the coded 4 pattern for carbon monoxide, you need to go to the coded pattern section of the program and put in the SSM bit for the carbon monoxide. Using verifier tools to program a Notifier 3030, we assigned a unique zone to each of the 10 CBE columns. After assigning the zones, we'll go to ACS mapping and monitor all 10 of those zones to see which ones activate. A smoke alarm activates CBE 1 through 3 and 6 through 10. A CO alarm activates CBE number 4. And finally, the thermal detector activates CBEs 1, 2, and 6 through 10. The most basic method to program a sounder base in Verifier Tools is to enable your sounder base, assign a zone in a smoke column, assign a zone in your CO column, set your temporal 3 tone with its pull down, give it the smoke zone, temporal 4, and then the CO zone.
If you look in the programming manual for the 3030, you'll see that the CBEs have other functions also. For instance, CBE 5 is for CO pre-alarm, and CBE 10 can be used as the action pre-alarm.